I have a pretty good relationship with them.
Yeah, so. You can do whatever you want.
Mom?
Who am I?
You are a gift.
You came here for a reason.
I know you feel different from other kids.
Touch the floor, Brian!
You are different.
Caitlin, get my hand up.
What are you doing?
First, congratulations on the movie. We saw it yesterday. It was great.
Thank you.
Where this wild idea came from?
Well, it came from my brother Brian and my cousin Mark. They wrote a screenplay about a family that adopts an alien baby that they find in the woods. And they brought that script to me and Dave Yarvo, the director, and we kind of pushed it to be a little bit more horror than it originally was. And that's where we ended up with this mashup of a horror movie and a superhero movie, which mm-hmm. are, of course, my two favorite things in the world, and made something really fun. And then we brought it to Elizabeth.
Yeah. And, I mean, I thought, first of all, it was so unique in the world building that they were going to do with the movie. And it really did feel like, I feel this way right now, which is I feel like a sort of a sucker for putting trust and hope into my heroes when on a daily basis I feel like we keep, you know, hearing about the bad things that everybody's doing. And, you know, we wanna believe that people have the greater good in their heart when they're in positions of power, that they believe Spider-Man's mantra, right? With great power comes great responsibility. And I just feel like that's not coming to fruition. And so I don't know, there's something really, I have a lot of anxiety about that idea right now. And I felt like this movie was a great way to explore that.
He's never bled. Not once in his whole life.
And did you talk with any of the people who has the rights to Superman? Were you worried at some point that this could be a problem?
Well, no, because there's a lot of similar, you know, stories that have been told in comic books over the years from all sorts of different comic book publishers. So, yeah. And I have a pretty good relationship with them.
Yeah, so. You can do whatever you want.
Maybe there is something wrong with Brandon.
I will never turn against our son.
He's not my son!
Hey, who's messing with me?
How this experience compares to the first time you worked together? If I'm not mistaken, it was in Slither,
yes.
2006. How does it compare to that, like 13 years ago?
I think the main difference is that Elizabeth has become a director since then. So being on set with her, last time it was Elizabeth the actor, and now it's Elizabeth the actor and filmmaker. And it's actually made her acting, I think, even better. She was always great, but it allows us to have conversations that are a little bit more all-inclusive about the totality of the film mm-hmm. Than it would have been back when we were doing Slither, when it was just about the moment and the scene and the interaction between the characters, or just that character's story, as opposed to how the whole thing works together. And it was a lot of fun having three directors on set with me, her, and Dave.
Anything to add?
No, he said it perfectly.
As usual.
Any thoughts on sequels?
Yeah, we have lots of thoughts on sequels.
We want people to go see this movie first.
We want people to go see it, yeah.
People need to go see this movie.
And then there'll be lots of sequels.
Then we can tell you all kinds of great stories.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I want to do good, Mom. I do.